What's up everybody, my name is Slanted, welcome back to another video. In this video, as you can tell by the title, we are going to be doing a full review and analysis as just a full timeline on the one and only character known as Finn the Human. Just Finn the Human for this one, as I plan to do more, but this is not a Adventure Time the series full timeline or anything like Channel Frederick's, which you should check out because that's amazing. But this is a Finn the Human timeline review, his whole lifespan, all the way pretty much through the beginning of the series to the end of the series. Now, obviously, if I went through every single thing through the beginning of the end of the series, then this would be a very long video lasting probably over an hour. So I will be narrowing it down to a few mega big things that aren't just random junk, and it's just going to be stuff that actually involves Finn's life. But yeah, if this video does well, I plan to make more videos like this, because this is actually kind of a video idea that I wanted to do for about a week now. I just came across it. I was like, oh, what if I did character timeline reviews of their whole lifespans, and what everything that's happened in their life from their birth to their death in a simplified summary that all mixes together for about a good normal-sized video. But yeah, without further ado, I hope you enjoyed the video. Let's get into it. First, I want to talk about the episode The Vault, where we were introduced to Finn's past lives, as reincarnation is this kind of a thing in Adventure Time, mainly with Finn. Some of these past lives would be a poop in another dimension, a comet or a catalyst comet, and a butterfly. But most importantly, Shoko. The past life, the one right before Finn was born, basically. I won't be talking about the other ones too much, like the butterfly or the comet, as much as Shoko, but they are semi-important, especially for a timeline about Finn. Finn's past life, known as Shoko, passed away under a tree, and then she pretty much just grew into the tree and made the tree, known as Finn and Jake's treehouse, which they would later live in. One thing about Shoko is that she was kind of a villainous character. She was a bit on the evil side, but not so much. But one key important part about her is that she didn't have an arm, which just added more tension and possibilities that Finn would eventually lose his arm, which he did, as that was kind of hinted and known that's destined to happen in multiple episodes throughout the entire series, whether it's past lives, future visions, or even alternate timelines. He always didn't have an arm. So that's just one more thing about Finn's timeline. He was destined to lose his arm in the future. But now we're already skipping to the future. We need to step back into the past, before Finn was even the hero we all know him as, when Finn was just a little baby. But before that, you need to know about the humans. The humans pretty much just desolated themselves to this island known as Founder's Island, or Tomb Red Tom's Island, as he is the founder. Whilst all the monsters or creatures or whatever you want to call them are outside of this place, somewhere else on the world, where they try to stay away from. Two people on this island were known as Martin, Mertens, and Minerva. Or, I should say, Finn's parents. Which, before what I'm about to say, you need to know this about Founder's Island. They're pretty much just playing a huge game of hide-and-seek on the island where, you know, the people find the hiders. And they are known as seekers. Hiders are people who try to leave the island. And seekers are the one who are supposed to stop them from doing so because they want them to be safe. Martin Mertens was sort of known as a hider of sorts, but he also plays between roles and sometimes acts like he is a seeker. Eventually, he got his legs busted by one of the seekers, and later on to meet Finn's mom, the helper, Minerva. Eventually, Martin makes some bad moves and has to retreat to the one and only hider waste to get away from these people just trying to, you know, stop him from being him. As well, Martin runs away, he takes Finn with him whilst Minerva comes inside to see that her son and her husband is gone, and she believes that he has retreated back to his hider ways. As Founder Island has a guardian of sorts that surrounds it, the guardian tries to stop him, but Martin decides, well, he needs to save Finn here, and he goes charging for this massive robot guardian and says that he'll be back, which we all know he never does, but he actually manages to stop the robot. But either way, after that, Minerva and Finn never really saw them again until way later in the series, but we'll get into that later. After Finn gets left on a raft in the middle of the ocean with his dad to never return, he washes up on a land called Ooh to be found by a family known as Joshua and Margaret, or Jake's parents. The parents are eventually deceased whilst they're still kind of babies until they eventually get old enough to move out and live in their epic treehouse, which then begins the so-called starting point of Adventure Time, where Finn and Jake or other characters go on a certain adventure where something always happens. Good, evil, interesting, creepy, unsettling, unsatisfying, amazing, sad, any of the sorts, and just many, many, many adventures throughout the entire series. A big part of it is kind of the love triangle circle of everyone and the whole, all of that, with the love for PB, which didn't work out, then the love for FP, which then when they broke up, that caused just hate and flame before Finn matured and they became friends and stuff, but for a while there, Finn was really depressed, and it was honestly really great. I loved those episodes. It was not good for Finn, but yeah. But yeah, besides all that stuff, going back to Finn losing his arm, Finn actually lost his arm in an attempt to save his father, who we were earlier told was alive in some place called the Citadel. So that's where he disappeared to after killing that guardian, I guess. But yeah, before all of this, one thing that happened is Finn got something called the Grass Blade, a curse blade that's pretty much just connected to his arm. This will be important for later, so remember this cursed Grass Blade that is just stuck on his arm that he decides to keep because he gets used to it, even though he thought it was kind of a curse before, but now he likes it. So it's kind of just canon that this is another thing that's part of his destiny. Before we get back to the arm whole Grass Blade thing, I want to talk about the episode The Comet, where they go to space to stop the evil being known as Orgalor, who is trying to absorb another Catalyst Comet, which comes 1,000 years every 1,000 years. And Finn was once one of these. He meets this Catalyst Comet.
Finn, do you remember?
Yeah, I think so. A long time ago, I was you, sort of. And I crashed on Earth and became a butterfly or some biz. And I guess it was just some random absurd thing. Just a joke I've been playing out for centuries.
Who's creating the joke? Are you? And if so, then are you my creator?
The Catalyst Comet asks this question after he remembers his past lives once more. It's the first time it's brought up since the episode The Vault. But the question is Finn the comet's creator? Which, honestly, he kind of is. As he was the Catalyst Comet before this comet, since it's every 1,000 years or so. But yeah, since the answer is kind of unclear to them, they say, well, Finn, you can basically become a god, or, well, come to the end and the beginning and relive everything and pretty much become immortal. And then we get a little recap of pretty much everything cool that has happened in the show so far, a bunch of the best moments yet, as the relationships, the anger, the hate, the friends, and the depression, of course, more anger, magic, just everything. The video games, the food, the crying, just everything that's happened in the show, and all the characters that mean so much. Not so much, but yeah, you get the point. Even though with all the pain and depression that Finn has been through, he still wants to live in this meat reality, even though, you know, it's kind of seemed as trash. Finn likes it. He enjoys his life. So he refuses immortality and just having probably the best life. Even though it would be good, he wants to stick to this meat reality and see what it has, what else happens. Oh yeah, also after this, we never see Martin again as he basically just gets wiped out. But yeah, he takes the deal and goes to be immortal and live this life and relive the ends of the beginning and all of that. So Martin is basically a god with this Catalyst coming now. So goodbye, Finn's dad. Just quick recap, since this isn't important, really. I mean, it is, but yeah, time. Finn heads the Founder's Island after being pretty much beaten the hell out of a human friend that was on Ooh, which we later found out was a seeker for a hider. And this hider was apparently Finn, since he kind of left the island all those years ago. Finn goes to Founder's Island to meet his mom and all the humans who are apparently still alive. Finn's mom is actually dead, and pretty much all the doctors on Founder's Island are dead since a virus hit As Minerva is the last helper left, but she's basically dead. She uploaded her consciousness to a computer to live. So yeah, that's kind of Finn's parents' timeline revolving into Finn's life. Before even any of this human Finn going to find his mom stuff, Finn got an alternate version of himself's consciousness subbed into a sword to make something called the Finn Sword, which then on accident kind of fused with the grass sword, which is a curse, made something called, well, Fern. A mixture of a consciousness of Finn and a grass demon. But the consciousness of Finn literally is Finn. So when the grass demon takes over Fern, or Finn, and tries to kill Finn, Finn accidentally kills Fern. Fern is found by someone evil eventually and put back together as he's just, well, grass, and brought back. But once he has a conversation with Finn, he becomes someone kind of good. And once they take out the grass demon to save the Finn side of Fern, this just makes Fern's body basically disappear. It's like a Thanos snap and a half, and Fern just kind of dies. So Finn's pretty much had to watch himself die twice now. Depression. There's obviously sort of a bunch of side important stuff that leads to Finn's life, but such as in the episode Puhoi. But yeah, I'm just not gonna spend time on that. As other than that, that's really everything that's happened from birth to the finale of Adventure Time. In the finale, basically, a war happens. So yeah. Last second before the war, Finn stops it, even though it kind of went on most of a bit of the episode to try to stop her, and like the episode before. So props to Finn for her dedication. But during this, Betty and Maja were trying to summon the being of Gulp, pretty much the main universal entity that's pretty much just a baby red god. Whilst Finn, Simon, and Betty try to stop Gulp, they get trapped on the inside, as they pretty much just slowly get digested, and Finn starts saying things such as, "Oh, I thought I was gonna go out saving someone," and this was one of the most emotional scenes in this episode, and it just hit really hard. Since Gulp is basically the definition of discord, music is able to stop them, as BMO and everyone harmonize a song together, which is beautiful for a finale. And everyone but Betty escapes the inside of Gulp, who decides to make a wish to save Simon and whatnot, but that's not important to Finn's life. Obviously, that's not all that there was to come along with me, as in the intro, that kind of confirmed that Finn and Jake were dead, and it was 1,000 years in the future, not the war and all that, but yeah. It's basically BMO 1,000 years in the future, even though everyone's dead, and BMO's a robot, so you know. But yeah, she's telling it to Shermie and Beth, or the reincarnations of Finn and Jake, as they're still together and still live on, even though they don't remember or know anything, and, well, they're here to ask BMO these questions. The end of Come Along With Me is the same as in the intro, with Jake, you know, lying there, or Beth lying there, and Shermie holding up, well, the Finn sword, which grew back into what was once the tree. And now the tree is massive, and it's just at the top. It's pretty much just Finn's deceased seed. So I guess they planted the Finn sword. But yeah, from all that I've said here is pretty much Finn's entire timeline in the series of Adventure Time from beginning to end. This is just the big stuff that I kind of remembered in Finn's life and that I know of. There's obviously probably more that I'm just not talking about or missing out on or not remembering, and that's my bad. But that is my full timeline on Finn's life. It's not really full timeline because obviously it's just the parts that are the most important, I feel. But I hope you do get what I mean and you get the gist of the video. So yeah, that's going to be it. If you did enjoy, please leave a like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one, whenever that is. My name is Slanted, and that was the Adventure Time character review for Finn the Human. Peace out.